Hello everyone. Okay, so in this session we will continue our lecture on the virtual work method. So in the previous session we have discussed on the example 3, 4 and 5, which is about the cantilever beam. Okay, so in this session we will discuss on the example 6. So what you can see in the example, we have a simply supported beam. So this beam is loaded by the UDL and the point load, and it is supported by the roller and pin at A and B respectively. So in examples, we need to determine the vertical displacement of point C. So given that the E is equal to 200 GPa and the I is equal to 150 times 10 to the power of 6. So the same concept will be applied. Okay, so for these problems, we need to have a real diagram and a virtual load diagram. So as usual, for the real diagram, the diagram can be exactly obtained from the equation. Meanwhile, for the virtual load diagram, so you need to remove all the load in the equation and apply one unit load. Okay, so since we need to find out the vertical displacement at a point C, so we need to apply one unit load at a point C, as what you can see in this diagram. Okay, so and the next step, you need to figure out the equation of moment. Okay, so by looking on this diagram of a real and a virtual diagram, you can see that we should to have two numbers of cut section, which is A to C, which is and C to B. So the range is 0 to 4 and 4 to 8 for AC and CB respectively. Okay, so let's we get the equation of moment for the virtual load diagram, for the real load diagram. Okay, so what you can see here is the solution of real load diagram. Okay, so for this particular example, so you need to calculate the direction before you can obtain the equation of moment for every cut section. Okay, so and by considering the three equilibrium equation that we always deal with. Okay, so by taking moment at A, so you can see that the direction at point B, the vertical direction at point B is equal to x in capital. And by considering the summation of force in vertical equal to 0, and you can get another vertical direction which is equal to 34 kN. And by considering the summation of force in horizontal equal to 0, you can see that the HV is equal to 0. Okay, so for the first cut section, which is A to B, okay, for the range 0 to 4, so this is a free body diagram. So we have a vertical direction which is equal to 34, which is at A. And we have a UDL load, which is 8 kN per meter. So by considering all the load and reactions, and we have the internal moment here. So the equation for the first cut sections is equal to 34x minus 4x squared. Okay. Meanwhile, for the second range, we have the same, the different situations of our diagram, where we have 20 kN point load here. Okay, so by considering these diagrams, you can see that the equation of moments is equal to 144 minus 18x. Okay, so we have done for the real diagram. So let's we move to the virtual diagram load. Okay, so for the virtual diagrams, you need to calculate the direction at support first prior to determine the equation of moment for every cut section. Okay, so and again, by using the three equilibrium equations, so you can see that here the direction at B is equal to 0.5, at A is 0.5, and HB remain the same, which is 0 kN. Okay, so let's we look on the first range, which is 0 to 4. So this is a free body diagram, and we have a direction at support which is equal to 0.5, and the internal moment Mx, so that's it for the reactions and the load in the system. So from that you can see that the equation of moment is equal to 0.5x. okay, so move to the another range, which is 4 to 8. Okay, so and here the one unit load. Okay, so actually this is one unit load, not the one unit moment. Okay, so change it to one unit load. Okay, so the one unit load is included in this particular free body diagram. So, and by considering all the forces and the internal moment here, you can see that the equation of moment is equal to 4 minus 0.5x. Okay, so I summarize all the equation of moment into this table. Okay, so since we have a two range or two limits, 0 to 4 and 4 to 8, so this is the equation of moment that we have obtained in the previous step. Okay, so and using the equation of visual work method for displacement, and so since we have a two limits, so you need to have a two terms here, 0 to 4 and 4 to 8. And applying all the equation of moment towards the equation of visual work that you can see here, and simplify this, carry out the integration process. You can see that displacement, the vertical displacement at point C is equal to 14.22 mm downwards. Okay, so that's it for the example 6. Let's remove to the example 7. Okay, so in example, you can see that we have a simply supported beam. Okay, but this beam is loaded by the point load 40 kN at 2 meter from support A. Support B, sorry. Okay, so in this example, we need to determine the slope at point C. Okay, so this point. So point C is located 2 meter from A. Okay, so given the E and the I here, you can see in the slide. Okay, so as usual, you need to have a two diagram. Okay, real load diagram and the virtual load diagram. Okay, so for the real load diagram, you just consider as the in equation. Okay, for the virtual load diagrams, we need to remove this particular 40 kN point load and substitute with the one unit moment where you need to apply this at a point C, since our objective is to determine the slope at a point C. Okay, so based on this diagram of a real and a virtual diagram load, so what you can see that for the real load diagram, we have two numbers of cut sections, which is 0 to 6 and 6 to 8. Okay, meanwhile, in the virtual load diagrams, we have two numbers of cut sections, but difference range from the real load, where the range is 0 to 2, okay, and 2 to 6. But in total, you're supposed to have three numbers of cut section. Well, you can see here. Okay, sorry. In this example, the step 2, step 3, which is referred to the moment equation for the real load and the virtual load respectively, are not shown here. So basically, what you can see in this solution for step 4, so as I said, there is three numbers of cut section, which is 0 to 2, 2 to 6, and 6 to 8. So I hope that you can figure out all these equations by your own, okay, and by drawing the free body diagram for each situation of a real load and virtual load diagram. So at the end, you're supposed to get that the angle is equal to this value, which is a 0.00111 radian, so in a clockwise direction. Okay, so that's it for example 7. So let's move on to example 8. So in this example 8, basically you need to solve for the slope at point B and C. So this is a free body diagram, so I don't want to discuss in detail on this, and the solution is not fully given here. So I hope that you can figure out the final answer by yourself. If you have a problem, you can contact me throughout WhatsApp or any medium that you are favor with. Okay, so that's it for topic of virtual load method. So in the next sessions, we will continue with the another methods. Okay, so thanks for listening. See you.